Hello everyone, welcome to my channel and welcome to this video. My name is Dr. Zui Nigurkar and I'm a first year radiology resident in Mumbai. And today's video is going to be all about first year of MBBS. I got a lot of comments from people who are joining MBBS this year to share exactly how you're supposed to study in MBBS. I fortunately had an older sibling who had already gone through first year and he gave me all the guidance I required when it comes to how to study. I think not everyone has that kind of a guidance, so I'm hoping that whatever I share today is going to be beneficial to somebody out there who is new to all this, because the study pattern is new, the exam pattern is new to us, the syllabus is so vast and your memory power is so little. First year is going to be a little hectic, but I'm hoping I can share my experience of how first year went and maybe it will benefit you guys. So let's talk about studies first, and I want to talk about it in four different aspects, that is lectures and practicals, self-study, studying for university exams and quizzes, presentations, etc. Talking about lectures and practicals, I'm going to speak about it very briefly. Disclaimer, it's going to sound a little boring and stupid, but for just this 1 year, please become a dedicated nerd. Be the first bencher. Be somebody who pays 100% attention in lectures. Somebody who asks so many doubts that all the other kids are annoyed. The reason why I'm saying this is because I spent my first year like this. It also did benefit me a lot when it comes to building the foundation of your first year subject, because all our lectures in first year used to be amazing. Like the information packed in every single lecture, in all the PowerPoint presentations that the lecturers used to make. Some things used to be derived from our own books that we refer to. Some stuff used to be from their PG books, which we will never read. And they used to simplify it and teach it. And that is amazing. And to lose out on resources like this is kind of stupid, to put it plainly. For just 1 year, try and not be that kid who is trying really desperately to reach that 75% attendance mark. Please be sincere this 1 year. Attend lectures. Be 100% attentive. Ask a lot of questions. Make a lot of notes. Also in practicals, try and be actively engaged. Don't just take everything that the teachers are saying word to word. Try and put your own mental effort into what is being taught. For example, it happens a lot of times that in anatomy dissection halls, we just watch what our professor is demonstrating on another cadaver and we try to recreate it on the cadaver that we are dissecting. But most of the times, we don't take the effort to actually sit and visualize mentally what the structure is in focus and what the surrounding relations look like. What is this structure going to look like in 3D? Like, you have to imagine all this when you're dissecting and you have to build all these concepts into your head, and only you can do that for yourself. Nobody is going to be able to spoon feed this information to you. And sooner or later, everybody has to do this, because when it comes to exams, you can't just mug up everything. You have to conceptually understand something so you might be able to write something in the exams, even if you don't remember reading it. So rather than doing it later, just do it sooner. Start right from the beginning when you are already attending lectures and attending practicals. If you start putting your 100% effort right from now, you will suffer less towards the end of the year you're preparing for your exams. Retrospectively, you're going to look back and think, thank God I was a nerd in first year and I did not half-ass my way throughout the entire first year. Second is self-study. All the information that you're learning in first year is very volatile. You're going to be able to remember it only if you study it in your free time, which means that this year you don't have the liberty of studying just before the exam. You will have to study a little bit throughout the year. So how is that going to look like? I think about 2 to 3 hours of studying daily is going to be enough. I used to aim for 4 hours of studying after college every day, but that hindered my social life a bit, which I will get to later. 2 to 3 hours should be enough. Even if you can just revise few points from the topics which were taught in lectures and tracks today, even that is going to be enough. If you can go through things quickly, you can look at the diagrams, you can look at the main points and try and recollect what was taught in lectures, simultaneously going through the notes which you had made during those lectures, this is going to be enough. You are solidifying the information which you learned in lectures. So later on, when before the exam you're preparing all this, you will not feel like the subject is unfamiliar or it's alien. You have already seen these concepts. You have revised them once. You have listened to lecturers teaching it once. Doing this daily is going to add up, and eventually before prelims and before university exams, all this combined effort is going to pay off. I think out of 3 subjects, you can combine 2 subjects. I used to personally do anat and physio together and biochemistry separately, because biochemistry was a weak subject for me. I did not find biochemistry really interesting, so I had to take extra efforts for that. Anat and physio were really interesting to me, and I really used to enjoy reading those subjects. So I used to read them together, and then I used to put extra effort into biochemistry. Also, when you're doing this kind of self-study, that is throughout the year, you're reading bit by bit, whatever is taught daily, you should be studying from a focus of building concepts and from a perspective of trying to understand the subject rather than trying to memorize things for the exam. So right now your self-study should be focused on trying to understand what is being taught and then coming to university exams. So now you have to start reading from a different perspective. Now you have to start building in your mind a short answer, a long answer, what kind of diagrams you're going to draw, what kind of answers you're going to write. So now your reading is going to be oriented in this perspective. The very simple funda of writing university exam answers is separate for anat, separate for physio, separate for biochem. The very simple funda of all anat answers is diagrams. You can literally make up a diagram in your own head which you have not seen in another book, and that is still going to fetch you more marks than what you would get by writing sentences alone. The examiners are trying to understand whether your visualization of anatomical structures is strong or not. And the best way to demonstrate this is always by the means of diagram and never by just writing sentences. I remember during our prelims, we had a short answer question on Trendelenburg gate. And that question was so new to all of us because nobody sits down to read Trendelenburg's gate in an anatomy book. But the concept behind it was taught to us during lectures. Then I remembered something about the gate, drew a diagram with just a stick figure trying to explain what the gate looks like and why it is caused, and then drawing a diagram of which structure is involved. You have to carry a box of colored pencils with you. You have to make a mental index of what each color represents. You know, when we are drawing in our anatomy journals, we have this index like brown is for muscle, green is for fascia, yellow is for nerve. Similarly, you have to make this mental index, and whenever you are trying to draw a diagram, you just follow this index with whatever colored pencils you're using. These diagrams are going to save your life when it comes to anatomy university exams. For physiology, it is all about flowchart. Physiology is basically just algorithm of your body. So if you can show that algorithm in forms of flowcharts, explaining the cardiac cycle in pictorial representation of a cycle, if you can explain the endocrinological pathways in our body step by step by flowcharts, what is causing negative regulation, what is causing positive regulation. Writing sentences, boring. Examiner is not going to read everything that you're writing. You draw a diagram, you draw a flowchart, the examiner understands, okay, this person's concepts are strong. That alone fetches you more marks. Just as simple as that. For biochemistry, it's a little tough. The answers are pretty straightforward. There is not much you can do. Even here, for enzymatic reactions, for general biochemistry, diagrams, flowcharts, it's always helpful. Any relevant reaction that you can remember to a certain answer, you should put that in there. Which defect causes what disease? These are all brownie points to impress the examiners. These are tricks which are never going to fail you. Then coming to quizzes and presentations. Even if you feel like you don't know anything, if you have an opportunity to sign up for a quiz, you should go for it. Because although you might feel really dumb in the moment when you can't answer things and others can, it's still going to compel you to read a little extra, put a little extra effort and try to understand things better. We used to have this MCQ exam for the entire batch. Through that, would select people for an anatomy quiz. Me and my team, we had passed our first round of the quiz and we were very happy with that. Then we went to the second round and then we lost really bad and felt dumb. But that is fine. That's not the point here. The point being that just for that quiz, I read a little extra. I read other books which I never would have read otherwise, which is why I will never regret, you know, looking dumb in front of an audience, because it has added to my knowledge eventually. And in the end, it has benefited me. If you have the opportunity to give presentations on any subject, do all these extra things, because if not for these events, you are not going to, you know, go out of your way to read a little extra. When you are presenting, when you're participating in quizzes, you need your knowledge to be solid. You put in 110% of your effort and it's only beneficial for you in the long run. Speaking of anatomy practicals and dissections and all that jazz, I want to share with you guys about a new platform called MedAce by Manipal. This is a fairly recent and new platform. It was made to cater not just for competitive exams like NEET and NICT, also for MBBS students throughout all the years, especially for first year MBBS students. They have two really amazing features, that is dissection lab, where they have more than 100 cadaveric dissection videos. In case the dissection you are doing personally during pracs is not enough, the atlas, like a 2D source which you are not being able to grasp so early in your first year, use these videos to complement whatever you are learning in college. Also, they have 3D interactive anatomy model. You can view them in a 3D space and that's going to help you understand the anatomical relations better. It's going to simplify anatomy by a lot. If you're finding it hard to plan and manage time, MedAce also has a feature called Study Planner. Suppose you're running short on time and there are certain subjects which are very important, which your seniors have told you are never to be missed. Take these very important topics. Even within that, there are must know points, good to know points. So you can select the must know points if you're running short on time. The app will combine all of this and they will give you a customized study plan. So you don't have to sit and predict how much time everything is going to take. Anterograde planning. That is a little tough when you are doing it for the first time on your own. So you can use this feature to plan out your studies. And in case you don't have very good notes of your own, the app also has handwritten notes and they have a lot of mnemonics, diagrams, graphs, tables. Very user friendly and very easy to memorize. Platform is actually very new and all these features sounded really interesting to me, which is why I wanted to share it with you. If you just want to try it out and see whether you like it or not, they have a 3-month subscription plan going on right now. You can use the code FESTIVE to get 45% off on the subscription price. Now coming to what books to use. Everybody knows that in first year there are two different categories of studying. One is conceptual and one is rectify for exam. So I'm going to share what books I used for both purposes. The first book for anatomy, which we all know about, is I think BD Chaurasia. It is recommended by all seniors everywhere. So they have a handbook for general anatomy and 4 volumes, out of which the 4th is for neuroanat. BDC is actually great for understanding things also. They have really simplified diagrams, which can be difficult to understand at first. But these are the diagrams which you will be memorizing to actually, you know, draw an exam. So BDC is a great book for preparing for exams. Initially, during first year, I was also reading this simplified version of the actual Gray's Anatomy. Technically, the only benefit with this book is that the diagrams are a little better and easier to understand. Also, the language of this book is less for exams and more for understanding. Reading it as if you're reading a book, it is easy to go through things when it comes to reading things for the first time. They have good tables and charts, good, clinical correlation points, which you can also add in your answers, like I mentioned earlier. So these are the two main books which I used for anatomy. Anat, I also sometimes refer to BDC, but most of the times I used to refer to Vishram Singh. So this book also has really good and simplified diagrams. They have good charts, good tables. I really enjoyed using this. Please make sure to go through all the relevant sections when it comes to neuroanatomy through the Netters Atlas. You're not going to find a volatile subject like neuroanat very tough if your concepts are strong and your anatomical knowledge is strong. When it comes to embryology, there are 2 books. One of them is really nice to understand concept. That's Langmann's. Absolutely stunning diagrams, and going through this is so fruitful and so rewarding when it comes to understanding anatomy conceptually. But it has really long sentences, long paragraphs. These are not very useful when it comes to writing answers. So that you use Inderbir Singh. Simplified diagrams, simplified paragraphs, short sentences which are more information packed. Inderbir Singh is the book to go with if you want to write good answers in exam. Physiology. Whether you are reading for concept or for answers, it does not matter. You cannot skip Guyton. Guyton is the Bible for physiology. If you are skipping Guyton, then you are skipping almost half of your MBBS knowledge, because this is relevant everywhere later on. It's going to be so relevant in medicine. You're going to be reading medicine whilst being clueless about physiology. You are going to be at a huge loss. Read Guyton like a book and read it to understand things. They also have good diagrams for answers. It is a little lengthy for writing answers, I admit. You are going to read Guyton no matter what. Yeah, I used to read with a lot of highlighters and a mental color coding system. Wherever feasible, I used to summarize and simplify paragraphs and what I understand from them in form of flowcharts like these. And once you have this, the next time you're reading this book for your university exams, you can skip all this and you can directly go to these flowcharts. Use that in your answers directly. Purely from an exam point of view, these 3 books were what I used. I used this book when I was extremely desperate and I could not find answers anywhere else. It felt like something that only had to be rectified, and I did not like to blindly rectify things, which is why I tried to avoid using this book as much as possible. AK Jain was amazing when it comes to reading for university exams. They have content given in form of points. They have beautiful diagrams which you can recreate in exam, which will also help you understand things better. If you are unable to use Guyton for answer writing purposes, I think you should be able to use AK Jain. Biochemistry. Sadly, I did not put that much effort into it. I really used to find the subject to be very dry and uninteresting. But I did use Vasudevan for biochem, and there is nothing much to explain here. You just have to read and memorize and understand. I can't find this book which I used in first year, but this is the same book which I used in second year. Bhalani was a question set which we used to get, and I had used the one before first year to find out the IMP questions. IMP questions is just the questions which have been repeated over past many years. So I used to go through all the past year papers and check over the last 5 years which questions have been repeated the most, study with those in mind when it came to the preparatory leave before your university exam. Because this is the second year book, so I had a similar book for first year and I used it thoroughly. And now that we've covered everything I wanted to cover when it comes to studies, let me talk a bit about your social life, your college life, and your mental space when you're in first year. One mistake which I made was, I was trying so hard to focus on my studies in first year and to, you know, revise everything that's being taught on the day itself, rush home, try and finish studying, try and reach my goals every day. I used to not spend a lot of time in the college campus itself. I did not make very solid friends for a very long time in first year because I isolated myself to study, which was a little dumb. At that time, I was so stressed about studying. The huge syllabus had freaked me out, but I should have spent more time being in college, being around people and, you know, talking to people, spending more time with others and trying to make friends. So if you are somebody who is freaked out by the amount of work that is there to be done, that work and that syllabus is never going to end. You're in MBBS now, you have to deal with it. You're never going to meet all the goals and all the expectations you have. Focus on your social life as well. Try and step out of your comfort zone. And even if you feel you are a little awkward, you have social anxiety, you are unable to talk to people without feeling really awkward and embarrassed, it's fine. Many people out there are going through the same thing. Not everybody is a social butterfly and not everybody gels with everyone around them immediately. It takes some time. So even if you have a few embarrassing interactions, even if you hang out with people and it does not feel like you match their energy, it's fine. You have to do this before you actually find your tribe, find the people that you vibe with, that you connect with. Unless you give it a try and unless you interact with others, you're not going to be able to figure out where exactly you fit in. Like, MBBS is 5 years long, but trust me, once you're done with it, it feels like it should have been longer and 5 years was nothing. Please, in first year, do not isolate yourself to study or do not isolate yourself because you don't have the confidence to interact with others. Step out of your comfort zone when it comes to all this. Whenever you have your college fest, any extracurricular thing which you can be a part of, go ahead and do it because this is going to help you develop your personality. You're going to try out new things and you're going to see whether you like it or you don't like it. Don't stress out about managing extracurriculars and studies at the same time because it all gets managed eventually. What is important is for you to make friends and memories through these events. Don't be scared to try out new things. Don't say no to all these activities just because you are stressed about studying. Your first year of MBBS is not going to come back. It's the only first year you have. A lot of things for the rest of your MBBS life are going to be determined by how your first year goes. Be less scared, more experimental, and put 100% of your effort when it comes to anything, whether it is studying, whether it is participating in extracurriculars, whether it is about making friends and hanging out with people. Like, you're either going to regret saying no to a plan or you're going to regret saying yes to it and going. But it can also happen that you might enjoy yourself, you might have a good time, you might make new friends. Say yes, put yourself out there a little more than you normally would. Hopefully your first year will be as memorable and as exciting as you expected it would be when you were in 12th standard back before NEET UG. I think this covers all the stuff I wanted to talk about when it comes to first year. I hope I did not bore you guys, and I hope whatever I said was at least a tad bit useful. It might not be applicable to everybody, but I'm just speaking from my own experience and what I wish I had done differently and what thing I feel like I did were right. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please consider liking the video and subscribing to this channel. I will see you guys in the next one. Goodbye and take care.